Hi guys, welcome to the 8th episode recap of Law School. Assemblyman Ko worries about meeting with Sol A and wonders how she got into law school. But the chief prosecutor assures him not to worry, since there's nothing much she can do. The talk then shifts to Jung-hoon, and the assemblyman insists the chief prosecutor to make Jung-hoon guilty. The chief prosecutor is confident, saying he has a secret weapon. At the courtroom, the chief prosecutor points out that it was Jung-hoon who insisted that it was a murder, when the detectives concluded it as a suicide. Jung-hoon argues back that he still stands with his belief of it being a murder. He also adds that if he really killed prosecutor So, he would gladly agree with the detectives, than insisting it to be a murder. As the judge wraps up the trial, the chief prosecutor tells him that he found an eyewitness of Jung-hoon killing prosecutor So, which surprises all in the courtroom. He also adds that he will keep the identity secret until the next trial. The website operator runs into Sol A and tells her that she has decided to do as she suggested. When Sol A worries over it, the operator assures her that even Professor Kim thought it'd be a better idea, and she wants to prove her innocence. She also adds, Joon-hee helped a lot with her trial. The operator tells her to study well and ace the exams for her sake. After the trial, Joon-hee meets with Jo and plays the recording he had made of the two reporters talking. They then finds the two reporters, and Jo asks them to become his witness, since he plans to indict the chief prosecutor. Joon-hee plays the recording he made of them talking. But the two reporters point out that recordings done in secrecy will not be considered proper evidence. To the surprise of the reporters, Jo takes out his phone, saying he recorded their current conversation for that matter. Jung-hoon also goes to the CCTV footage of the school and finds Sang Jae having his laptop. Since he has covered his face, he fails to recognize him. Professor Kim recognizes him from his ring. Yong-chung tells Ji Sul that she is the witness the prosecutor talked about. Yong-chung forces her to testify, as he says. But she refuses to become the false witness and leaves. Yong-chung steps on her feet and tells her that Jung-hoon is getting away with the murder, using his knowledge in law, and this is the only way to get him. Joon-hee sees Yi-sul entering the school, and when he calls out for her, she trembles. She asks him if he believes Jung-hoon is not the killer. Joon-hee tells her that he trusts no one, since he was betrayed by the one he trusted the most. So now, he only believes the facts. He adds that he said the truth at the trial, since they can't lie if they want to work in the field of law. He then leaves the statement Yong-chung wrote, promising not to harm her again. She receives a video from the spy cam Yong-chung made of them, and he threatens her to do as he says. Jung-hoon and Joon-hee talks over the evidence they've collected against the chief prosecutor. Joon-hee also points out that out of prosecutor So's belongings, his glucometer is missing. The next day, Sol A nags about missing the notes on subrogation rights of Professor Kim's lecture. While she nags, Joon-hee walks into the coffee room, and she refused to talk with him. She yelled at him for not letting her know about the website operator and for he being a smarter student. So Joon-hee offers to help her, to which she agrees, and immediately makes up with him. So on the next passing days, Sol A studies hard with the help of Joon-hee. She even hits her hand with a pen when she dozes off. Joon-hoon walks in while Professor Kim finalizes her question paper. She points out that Yong-chung is using Yi-sul to get back at Jung-hoon for humiliating his father. Since Yi-sul seems to be solid in her relationship, it is most likely she does as Yong-chung says. If that happens, Jung-hoon will end up taking the fault. So Professor Kim insists him not to rely on Yi-sul's conscience too much. Jung-hoon stresses her to talk with Sang-jae, since the testimony of his alibi is the only way out for him. In the meantime, we see Sang-jae hacking into Professor Kim's computer and copying the exam questions. Professor Kim confronts Sang-jae about Joon-hoon's laptop. He just tells her, saying everything is her fault. On his way out, Joon-hoon hears Sol-ae's alarm going off, and on her sleep she mutters that subrogation rights is the hardest. Joon-hoon plays the alarm on her ear and wakes her up. As he leaves, Sol-ae tells him that she won't repeat his class and that even Professor Kim agreed with her on the website operator's case. Joon-hoon yells at her for considering herself equal to Professor Kim and mentions the paper she has written about subrogation rights. Sol A picks it up and refers to the paper. Joon-hoon goes to Mun-ho's place. Mun-ho confesses that Dun volunteered at the orphanage his son was, and they became pretty close. He confesses that he is looking for Dun because he wants to find his son. Joon-hoon admits that he is looking for Dun as well and managed to get a hold of her recently. Just as then, he gets a call from Dun. When Mun-ho asks for the number, Joon-hoon tells him to confess first about who bought him, to testify against him. He offers him time to think and walks out. During the test, Sol A passes out because she has exhausted herself studying. Sung Jae attends to her at the hospital and finds the wounds caused by her pen. Joon-hee, Bak-ji, and Yoo-bam also visits her in the hospital, which she finds uncomfortable. So she gets discharged immediately. The students talk about the new witness that will be testifying in the next trial. Sol A is sure enough that the witness is a false witness and will have no impact on Joon-hoon's case. Yi-sul walks in and confesses that she is the witness. More than anyone, Sol A is surprised to hear this. On the trial day, Yi-sul overhears Sol A becoming suspicious about Joon-hoon for the first time, since it's Yi-sul who is testifying. In the trial, Joon-hoon wears sunglasses, claiming that eye contact with Yi-sul might frighten her. When the prosecutors questions her, Yi-sul says the exact things Young Chung taught her. But when Joon-hoon's attorney take over, Yi-sul breaks down and admits that she lied. She exposed Young Chung made her do it by threatening to disclose their private video to the internet. Young Chung runs out of the courtroom, while Yi-sul apologizes. That night, Sol A decides to sleep with her. When Sol A leaves to get her pillow, Yi-sul gets a call from Young Chung. She then leaves to meet with him, and Sol A finds the room empty. Young Chung threatens to publish the video of them, and Yi-sul tries to stop him. In the process, Young Chung trips and hits his head, falling unconscious. She trembles and makes a call to Sol A. Joon-hoon comes from behind and grabs the phone, and with that the episode ends. This episode reveals quite a deal. Yi-sul and Song Jae will have quite a handful in the coming episodes. Join with us on our next episode recaps. Thank you so much for watching, and please like, comment, and share this video. I'll see you again in another video.